Well, thank you, Chairman Padilla, and thanks to each of our witnesses for being here today. I'm proud of this country's commitment to offering a place of refuge to people fleeing persecution on account of their race, their religion, their nationality, membership in a particular social group, or political opinion. Just over 2 years ago, I collaborated with the chairman of this committee, Senator Durbin, to hold a hearing in this subcommittee on how the United States can support Hong Kong's pro-democracy movement through our refugee policy. I also joined Senators Rubio, Coons, Tillis, Durbin, and others to encourage the Secretary of State to grant priority to refugee status to Uyghurs who are being persecuted by the Chinese Communist Party, basically held in concentration camps, about 1 million Uyghurs in the People's Republic of China. America should continue its tradition of welcoming refuge and resettling those fleeing oppression. President Ronald Reagan, in his first year of office, stated, "More than any other country, our strength comes from our own immigrant heritage and our capacity to welcome those from other lands." He went on, however, to say, "No free and prosperous nation by itself can accommodate all those who seek a better life or flee prosecution. We must share this responsibility with other countries." And that's what the Refugee Resettlement Program does. No refugee can self-select their coming to the United States. They can be resettled in a number of other countries. All free nations need to share that commitment. But we should not lose sight of the fact that the refugee system is fundamentally about providing a path to safety, not necessarily a path to the United States. Furthermore, the U.S. Refugee Admissions Program is not the solution to the chaos and the crisis that we see on our southern border. In January, President Biden announced a new measure to address the border crisis, including a provision that would welcome up to 20,000 refugees from Latin America and Caribbean countries during fiscal years 2023 and 2024. I understand that the administration's new strategy includes other components as well, most of which I believe will merely camouflage the severity of the problem we're experiencing. But let's be clear. Increasing refugee resettlement is not the solution to what we see on the border happening today. In each of the last two fiscal years, U.S. Customs and Border Protection encountered 1.3 million migrants from Mexico and Northern Triangle countries. So at the pace of 20,000, this is a drop in the bucket. It will not alleviate the strain caused by the current crisis on our southern border, and it will not prevent migrants with weak or non-existent asylum claims from unlawfully crossing the border. The solution to the crisis lies in enforcing our immigration laws and deterring migrants from undertaking the dangerous journey to the southern border when they do not have a valid basis for asylum. Unfortunately, the Biden administration has not shown a willingness to quickly remove migrants with frivolous or no asylum claims. So there's just simply no consequences associated with coming here, claiming asylum, being released into the interior of the country, perhaps never to be heard from again. Certainly, the administration has taken zero efforts to actually, once people fail to show up for their asylum hearing, assuming they can get one in a reasonable period of time, those who don't qualify, there is no program or system for removal of those individuals who don't meet the legal threshold for asylum. Just last week, the New York Post reported that a migrant who was paroled, which means in this context to be released into the United States, to await a future court hearing. The New York Post reported that a migrant who is paroled in New York City today will have to wait until October 2032 to receive his or her notice to appear, which starts the immigration court process. That's a 10-year wait to even begin the process. Meanwhile, that individual's set down roots, perhaps married, has children, and it is a disservice to those with valid asylum claims to make them wait so long when 85% or so of the individuals who do actually present in front of an immigration judge do not qualify. It's unfair to those who do qualify. Paroling a migrant into the United States and waiting nearly a decade to start deciding whether or not he or she has a valid asylum claim is absurd. But that's just another consequence of the current policy by this administration at the border. I think this stands in stark contrast to the sober, deliberate process of considering refugee applications through the U.S. Refugee Admissions Program. But you look at the number of that President Biden's administration has set for the cap for a year, it's 125,000. During the first 2.5 years of the Biden administration, we've seen 5 million migrants show up at our southern border. So 125,000 is not a significant number when considered in that context. But the process is sound, I believe. Applicants for the U.S. Refugee Admissions Program undergo multiple rounds of interviews and submit to multiple and continuous background checks to determine whether or not they pose a safety or security risk to the United States. Their biographic and biometric information is checked against the U.S. Department of State, the Department of Homeland Security, Department of Defense, FBI, and National Counterterrorism Center Holdings. And there's a randomness factor, too. The likelihood that any individual refugee will be sent to the United States is low, so low that it is a poor vehicle for terror groups of those who intentionally want to come to the United States to do so. It's a whole lot easier to show up on the border and claim asylum and then be paroled under current policies into the United States. So I don't believe the Refugee Resettlement Program represents a substantial safety risk, but I'm anxious to hear what the witnesses have to say. When a refugee is finally admitted to the United States, he or she is qualified as a refugee. Although no system is perfect, we've taken significant measures to screen out those who would seek to do us harm or come misrepresenting their circumstances. So again, this stands in sharp contrast to the chaos we see at the southern border. Since the beginning of the Biden administration, more than 800,000 migrants have been paroled into the United States. Again, this is the process by which they show up. They're given a notice to appear or told to report for a future court hearing, but then released into the interior of the United States. Again, and only a small percentage, maybe 15%, ultimately qualify. And many don't show up for a court hearing, but there's never a process, a systematic way to try to remove those who do not qualify, even if they don't show up. We will not begin to decide whether they qualify for asylum for years. In some cases, as I said, more than a decade, but we know historically that about 85% do not qualify for asylum. And again, if you think about the unfairness to people who actually do, making them wait for 10 years before actually getting an asylum hearing, because of the backlog caused by people who do not qualify, is very unfair. Security screenings for migrants at the border does not even begin to approach the rigorous process refugees undergo. True, Border Patrol has successfully screened out some criminals and individuals who matched records on the terrorist screening data set. And I look forward to asking General Burns about his experience. And the numbers are increasing. In 2020, Border Patrol apprehended only 3 individuals who matched records on the terrorist screening data set. That number has increased to 15 in fiscal year 2021, to 98 in 2022, and 69 so far in 2023. In other words, in 2023, 69 people so far who were apprehended, we're not talking about the gotaways, the ones that were apprehended, were on the terrorist screening watch list. Well, in fiscal year 2022, we don't have an exact number, but it's estimated that there are about 600,000 migrants who did not run to the Border Patrol to claim asylum. They ran away from the Border Patrol because, frankly, they knew they couldn't qualify, or they knew that they were transporting drugs, or for some other reason, they would not be able to legally make it into the United States. Recent estimates in the media place this number for fiscal 2023 at more than 350,000 gotaways so far. I recently was in El Paso with some colleagues at a night patrol where they detained two gentlemen from the People's Republic of China. This is El Paso, Texas. The People's Republic of China is a long way away. And we don't really know why they decided to come to El Paso, Texas, or what they will do once they are paroled into the United States awaiting a immigration court hearing. We should, together with the rest of the world, offer protection to victims of persecution. There's no difference between us on that score, but allowing chaos to persist at the southern border is counterproductive, to say the least. The Biden administration can do better and must do better. We need a safe, orderly, humane, and legal system for people to come to the United States. I believe we have that in the Refugee Resettlement Program. We do not have it at the southern border, thanks to the administration's failed policies. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Cornyn.